ओके, आर यू क्लियर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लाइन, और यू वांट मी टू रिपीट? सो दैट्स वेरी क्लियरली व्हाट शी टोल्ड. इफ यू लीव ए वेरी वेरी स्मॉल पॉजिटिव टेस्ट चार्ज अलोंग विच पाथ द टेस्ट चार्ज मूव, that path is known as electric field line.
Electric field.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
So if you're trying with a positive test charge, case one, I have a charge which is Q greater than zero. Means?
Positive.
Yeah, positive. So this is plus. So if you want to find the field direction, what you should do?
Leave a vanishingly small positive test charge.
Yeah, try at different points and see which direction it will move.
Radially outward.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, radially outward. So it's clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So what about negative test charge?
Inward.
Yeah, it's correct. If you are okay, tell me that I don't want to waste time on that. You can move for more questions and finish the concepts. Is okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then what about a dipole? You go for a dipole. Dipole has one plus and one minus.
Yeah, same magnitude.
So if you have one plus here, and one minus here equal magnitude, what's supposed to be the field line if you leave a test charge here?
Plus I cap.
Or plus
I. Yeah, so it's pushed away from the plus charge and attracted towards the
negative charge.
If I leave a test charge here, it's supposed to go like this.
Yeah.
If the negative was not there,
it'll go towards the negative.
So it starts from that way, but because of the negative, it can't go straight. It starts curving and will end up on the negative one. It's the same way on the top also. What about this
one? This is for dipole?
Yeah, this is for the dipole. Dipole is one plus and one minus, right? Equal opposite.
Yes, sir.
What about the right extreme point here? This point, right extreme point here.
Move towards minus.
Yeah,
there are two effects, but you know who is stronger at that point?
Negative.
Yeah. Negative.
So it will be attracted towards negative only, right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So this will be the direction. So what about the left extreme point?
Minus.
Yeah. What about this point between the two, like here?
It'll move away.
Yeah, it's supposed to go radially outward.
Try moving towards negative.
Negative. So it goes start, but it have a curve towards negative. Same with this also starting, but curve towards negative. It's fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you have a neutral point for a dipole?
Yes.
Neutral point means?
Force is zero.
Force?
Yeah, net force or field is zero.
Yes, sir.
How, which point, where?
If the charges are equal, then it would be the midpoint.
Midpoint.
But you have a plus and minus, right? Imagine the direction of the force, what will happen on the test charge? You leave it, yeah.
I didn't get it.
Did you get the question what I asked?
Yes, sir.
No. Can it have a neutral point?
Yeah. What's the meaning of neutral point?
Net force is zero.
Yeah, what's the condition for net force to be zero, the prime condition?
equal magnitude opposite direction.
Yeah, equal magnitude comes the second condition.
Opposite direction.
Yeah, if the directions are opposite only, you have to check for the magnitude. If the directions are same, nothing to think about the second condition. Not possible. Net force can be zero only if the directions are opposite. Then you think about the values are equal or not. So can you find any point in the field, left, right, top, down, anywhere, the fields are exactly opposite? Exactly opposite. Helena, central point, what will happen?
It will go towards minus.
Yeah, so there's no opposite direction, right?
No.
So you can't have a zero between the two. What about the left side of the positive charge?
It will go opposite.
You can have opposite directions, right?
Yes.
The plus will push left. The minus will attract right. But the plus will be always stronger than the negative. Why?
Yeah. Because it's closer.
Closer, yeah. So you can't have a point going afterwards. The same situation here also, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So, can you have a neutral point for a dipole?
No.
Even you take a point here somewhere, what will happen at this point? What will be the effect of plus?
It'll push it away and minus will pull it closer.
Like this, right?
Yeah.
And minus will be like this, right? Can it be zero?
No.
Zero is only possible if they are in
opposite direction.
Yeah, if opposite direction satisfied, then you check whether there's possibility of magnitude be equal or not.
Yeah.
Then only we understood here, the left hand side directions are opposite, but magnitudes can never be equal.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Yes, sir.
Divya?
Yes, sir.
So what about two equal positive charges if I try? Two equal positive charges.
Yes.
It's possible.
Yeah, it's possible.
It might be in the midpoint.
Yeah, correct. Exactly in the
midpoint.
Midpoint. The directions are opposite and even the magnitude also will be equal. So that's a neutral point. The importance of neutral point, left of the neutral point, Q1 will be stronger. Points. Right of the neutral point, Q2 will be stronger. Only at neutral point, both are equal and opposite. Mm-hmm. So what about the field lines then?
It will be opposite.
You can imagine again what happens if you put a positive test charge. What happens here left?
Minus I cap.
Yeah. Both are pushing only. Right extreme beyond the positive charge?
Plus I cap.
Okay, what about this point above?
Can you see it?
It go from here radially, but there's a plus. So?
It'll curve away.
Yeah, curve away. Same here also. Fine.
Yes, sir.
This also will be curving away. What about two equal negative charges?
Same thing.
All the arrow marks will be inward. That's fine.
Yes, sir.
What about if it's one is plus and one is less and one is more? Both are plus, but one is greater, one is less.
It should be closer to the less one.
The lesser one.
So Q1 is greater than Q2. So is the null point at the center?
No.
It will be
Closer to
Q2.
Yeah, so it'll be somewhere here. Null point.
Yeah.
So the field will be in such a way, Q1 just push much stronger on Q2, right? The effect of Q1 on the test charge will be more than that of Q2 because Q1 is stronger.
Yeah.
So the field line will be much curved, like it's frightened by seeing the test charge. Yes?
Okay.
You can see the effect of Q1 is more dominating over the effect. I've drawn more lines to indicate.
Stronger.
Yeah, this is idea. Stronger charge, we need to draw more field lines. Number of lines proportional to the strength of the charge. What about if both are minus? Both are minus, Q1 is greater again. Same thing, right?
Same, but inverse.
What about uniform electric field? The word will tell you what.
Equidistant.
The lines will be equidistant and parallel.
Parallel.
Uniform electric field is a vector, right?
Yes.
So both magnitude and direction has to be same.
Yeah.
Direction same. Okay, this is direction same. How to indicate magnitude is same?
Equidistant.
Yeah, magnitude, if you draw field lines like this, this indicates strong field.
Yes, sir.
If the field is weak, they will be far apart. So, uniform electric field, the field lines are parallel and?
Equidistant.
So, do this charge produce uniform field or not? Plus charge. This you leave. Not this. Only this. Does it produce uniform field?
No.
No, it all cancelled.
See, all the properties are violated. They are not in the same direction.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Are they equidistant everywhere?
No.
So, now we go back to the properties one by one. You can tell me from where to where the field lines start moving?
Positive to negative.
Okay. If there is a positive and negative, it will move from positive to negative. Only positive?
Stronger charge to weak. No.
No, only positive. Nothing else.
Away from positive.
Radially outward till infinity. Like.
Yeah.
For a single negative, from infinity towards a charge.
Inward.
If there's plus and minus, definitely from what? Plus to minus.
Positive.
Okay. Then, what about the direction of the field? If you have a field, then how do you find the direction of the field using field? I have a plus charge here. I have a minus charge here. So, this is the direction of field. This is the direction of the field. How do I find the direction of electric field intensity at this?
Same, right?
I didn't hear clearly.
It's the same direction.
Yeah, same direction means
from positive to negative, the same as the field line.
Yeah, but I want that particular point exactly at only at point A. Okay, if you revolve a stone,
tangent.
Yeah. So, if you leave the stone at this point, what will happen? Will it go in circular path?
No, straight. Straight. It will go.
So, that's the direction of velocity at that point, right?
Yeah.
Even the object is continuing the circular path, we say at that particular point, the direction is along the tangent. Same way, if I want to find the direction of the field at A here, what you should do? You imagine when the test charge reaches at A, you take away plus and minus. What will happen? You take off plus and minus. Will the charge continue the path?
No.
When the charge go along this?
Tangent to the...
Drawn out to that point, right?
Yes.
It will continue the path only if the plus and minus is existing there. So if I want to find the field at this point, what should I do?
The tangent.
Yeah, that's it. Any point. Not only that point. So direction of electric field intensity is along the
tangent
to the electric field line at that point.
But that's only if we ignore the charges, right?
Yeah, that's the meaning of what you say field at that point. Why it's curving? Next point. Why it is curving at next point? Because the charge is present.
Okay.
At that point, it's supposed to go that way. Next point, it's supposed to go another way. It's continuing and changing the path only because the force is continuously pushing the or pulling the charge towards that.
Okay.
So first property was direction of the field. Right?
Yeah.
Even you told me by direction is from plus to minus, but each and every point the tangent will give you the direction of the field. Yes?
Yes.
Any other properties you remember so that I can add along that? We discussed two.
Density.
Yeah. So density.
Field how you lines is. It's greater where the charge is more.
Yeah. That means crowded field lines indicate.
Stronger charge.
Stronger charge.
Yeah. They're perpendicularly outwards from the surface.
Surface only for a conductor, okay? For a conductor, if you have a metal, the direction of the field line has to be normal to the conductor starting and ending. Why? Niharika?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, why? What is the property?
The conductor one?
Yeah.
The parallel to the surface.
Correct.
Because I don't know why.
Divya want to say something to you.
I don't have anything. I think Alina knows it.
No.
No, you listen to what she told?
It's perpendicular.
Yeah, yes. She told surface. Perpendicular.
She said
parallel. You said normal to the surface, right?
Yeah, normal means
perpendicular.
Yeah.
Perpendicular.
So, yeah. But I heard you told parallel. I feel maybe I'm wrong like sometimes.
No,
maybe I heard something around this point. This is the direction of the electric field only for a
conductor.
I asked the reason for that. Why?
Because it has.
The direction, then when you resolve it.
Yeah.
Then the parallel vector would.
Okay. You say if it is like this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. You resolve, you get one component here, one component perpendicular.
Yeah.
So
the parallel one would some
correct. You can continue. It's same. What you said is right.
No, I then, don't.
Okay.
Would give the property to.
Like, I don't know how to move the charges, right? So, and we are focusing on static charges.
Yeah, correct. Can you continue?
The conductor has the ability to carry charges, and the parallel point would give the movement for the charges.
Yeah. Okay. If this is a conductor, what's the difference of a conductor from an insulator?
It allows you to.
Can you give so many electrons here? Can you just concentrate all the electrons here in a conductor?
No.
They're
not. Spread out, right? Spread out equally to all the sides, like. Yes?
Yes, sir.
If we give a electric field, what happened to the electrons? If you given apply an electric field, what happened to the electron? I have an electron here. This is electric field. Did the electron stay there?
No.
It is plus and this went minus. So electron will be pushed by this and pulled by this, right?
Yes.
So electron start moving. Yes. I don't know. This is fine with you. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So this is the electron. If the electron is left in a field, will it move or not?
Yeah. It will.
It will move if the medium supports its movement, right?
Yeah.
If it's an insulator, it can't move because insulator charges can't flow. But if it's a conductor, if it's a field, definitely the electrons tend to move. They will move. But we are learning, that's why she started with, chapter name is what?
Electrostatics.
That means charges should be at what? Charges should be stationary at rest. So if you have a field line like this, what will happen now?
The charges will flow.
Charge cannot go out of the metal.
No, I mean.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Can you resolve that into two? Theta, this E. One component will come as what?
E cos theta.
That E sine theta. Yeah, E sine theta, I'm not interested because the charge cannot go out of the metal. Charge cannot jump out of the metal, but charge can easily flow through the metal. Like.
Yes.
So, if there is a field like this, will the electron move?
Which field?
You have E here. Can you see E?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
This is E. Okay?
Yes, sir.
The E has a component called E cos theta here, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, will this electron stay stable here, stationary?
No.
This will move from what, plus to minus, minus to plus, right?
Yeah, minus to plus.
Yes. So that is not applicable in electrostatics.
Don't all charges move anyway?
Charges will move only if there is a field. Otherwise, they randomly move, they get balanced. Electron will go, one will come and balance. But here all the electrons start moving towards a plus.
Okay.
So this is a point when you're not clear, you should ask and get it clear while like ask the questions. Not okay, just don't adjust and go. All the charges in a conductor are randomly moving. If I have a conductor like this, I don't apply any field, okay? No field is applied.
Mm-hmm.
One electron will go here, so another electron will come and compensate.
Mm.
Right?
Yes. So in a conductor without field, the charges keep moving.
Yeah, there's no free electrons.
Yeah, there's no need for a charge.
Yeah, there's no electric field for the random movement.
Okay.
But that random movement will be balanced. You can't say all the electrons will come and stay here.
Mm-hmm.
When one electron go from A to B, another electron will come and join there. That will be compensated by different like. No pressure difference, right? Pressure difference creating wind. Mm-hmm. Like wherever low pressure, air will come and fill that. So getting balanced. But if you apply a field, if I am applying minus, what will happen? I am applying minus from outside.
Then the charges will repel.
Yeah. Then electrons all go away from that, right? All will go, not one.
Yeah.
The compensation will not work there.
Mm-hmm.
So same way, if you apply an electric field which is not normal to the surface. What will happen? All the electrons in the conductor start moving against the field. Is it possible in electrostatics?
No.
It's possible in electrodynamics. Electrodynamics.
Mm-hmm.
Electrodynamics means current electricity. When you apply plus side and minus side of the battery to a conductor, electrons can move. In that case, it's fine. But we are speaking about? Static charges. For the charges to be static, there should not be any force on them. If they should not have a force, the field line has to be normal.
Yes.
Why can't the field line pull the electron out of the metal then? That also force only, no?
Yes.
Yeah. I told you, if this is a conductor, you can't have field like this because the electrons are pulled by the field in this part, E cos theta. What about this one can't pull the electron out? That also can pull the electron out.
Yes.
But it is not sufficient.
Yes,
like
sir.
When the electron tend to go out, this develops a positive polarity.
That pull back.
That pull the electron back. Right?
Yes. Sir.
But here
sir.
Is a free conductor. They are free to move. Like, so just a small plus minus enough to make them water flow. Can you tell me confirmed reason? It's a question asked why. One more question. Niharika. I'm not troubling you. Just try. We'll see.
So can you repeat the question?
Why can't electric field lines incline? Why it has to be normal for a conductor?
Because when you resolve it, the charge will move along E cos theta.
Okay. Then you should say one line before that. If the field lines were not normal, right?
The field lines were not normal, then it would.
When you resolve that, you get a component E cos theta parallel to the surface.
Parallel to the surface. So the charge will move along.
The charge moves because of the field. That movement of the charge is not possible in what? Electrostatics.
Electrostatics.
The charge has to be stationary. That there should not be any field line parallel. That means field line has to be what? Normal to the conductor.
Okay.
So one more question. Okay. Any other properties you remember? Then we can just wind up that area. It's a direct question. Can two field lines intersect at a point?
No.
No. Why?
Two directions.
That point they would have more than one direction, which is not possible.
Okay. Field line is actually what? Field line is a path followed by?
The
test charge. Test charge. Can a test charge simultaneously move in two directions at one point?
No.
I think this already you studied somewhere in grade 10 in magnetic field lines also.
Yes.
The compass needle cannot show
the compass needle can't. Yeah.
Okay. Any other properties other than this?
Inside a conductor, there are no electric field lines.
Okay. Same. My word. Good. So, can you tell me the reason? This is a conductor. Why the electric field is zero inside?
Because it opposes the direction of the electric field outside the conductor, so it gets cancelled out.
Yeah, if this is electric field, this is plus, this minus, right?
Yes, sir.
Because of this plus, what happened the left end of the conductor, AB?
Negative charge.
Negative. The right end develop a
positive charge.
So it have a field induced inside from its plus positive. And minus. So this applied field and induced field get?
Yeah.
That's why electric field is zero inside a conductor. Okay. So, and one more property you told me in the beginning when I asked you the electric field line definition.
Directly proportional to the charge.
Yeah, even the first quantity when I asked you, I don't know who told, I don't remember that time. You defined in terms of the number of lines per unit area.
Yeah.
Electric field intensity can be calculated as number of field lines per unit area.
Unit area. Yes.
So that's another property. If you want to find electric field intensity point, take one unit area around that. See how many lines are passing through that. That's called the electric field intensity. Yes.
Yeah.
So. Yes, these are the basic properties of electric field lines.
Yes, sir.
Can we move from this point then?
Yes, sir.
This is a question. They're asking which field line represent correctly satisfying all the properties in the diagram.
Is that a conductor?
Yeah, that's a conductor. That sphere is a conductor.
A.
C.
A.
D.
What property it is satisfying?
It's a conductor, right? So yeah. There are no field inside.
Okay, fine. Right. Thank you.
But then A also would be that.
No? It's not normal. The surface.
Yeah.
But it's a circle.
None of them are normal. Is D not the circle?
B and C not possible because?
Yeah. There's an electric field inside the conductor.
Okay. A is not possible because?
It's not normal to the surface.
Okay. D is not possible. Why?
D is also not normal.
No, D is normal. Exactly. You can see.
Normal. It's a little bit
but
numb.
Then it's a bend.
Yeah, bend. They don't right? say it should be normal throughout.
Oh. Okay.
We don't ask you starting from the material should go throughout normal like this. We don't demand like this.
So is it because one arrow is going inside then both come outside?
That is okay. That may be indicating this side as minus and this side as plus, right?
Yes, sir.
My point is, it is coming curved, but see what happening at the end here, becoming 90 degree, right?
Okay.
So you don't want 90 degree from the beginning till last like this. That's what I mean. It's not needed. It is just enough to be normal at the point of contact. After that, it can bend. You're not clear.
Yes, I am.
Okay, I have a metal piece here. I'm keeping a plus charge here. How the field lines you draw? This is one more question again. Because of the plus, what will happen? Because of the plus.
The negative.
Yeah, negative.
That will be negative, right?
Yeah.
Will induce negative charge.
And the other end will be plus.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Then how the field lines will come? This is a conductor, okay?
Inside the conductor, outside.
Inside the conductor, you know, right? You just told me inside is zero, yeah. Right?
Towards yeah. the conductor.
Yeah. It will be like this.
Yeah.
And the second field line will be like this.
Yes.
That is 90 degree, right?
Yeah, it's perpendicular.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not 90 degree from here. Only at the meeting point has to be 90 degree.
Okay.
You can't make a field line like this wrong. Why? It's not following 90 degree, like ending and leaving 90 degree. This is wrong. This field line is wrong.
Okay.
Then this is correct one, like. And from the other side, it should go like this, starting.
Oh.
If there are some other... Yeah.
It bends to get 90 degree on the conductor.
Yeah, it has to be 90 degree on the conductor.
Yeah, so that's why it's bending to get... Okay.
So why can't it be straight completely?
This one, right?
Yeah.
That same thing will happen. If you resolve this into two components, you get two components like this. This can make the conductor move, electrons move in the conductor parallel to the surface.
Okay.
Electrostatics, there's no possibility. Total electrostatics.
Okay.
So the correct one is D, right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Because inside is zero. It's ending normal, it's starting normal. Yes?
Yes, sir.
I don't mean normal means starting from that point till infinity should go normal. No meaning like that. Only at the point of contact, it has to be normal. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then I'll go for one more question then, if it's okay for you.
So do we have generator and all that this year?
No, that's AC generator is coming later, okay, not in this chapter. You've seen one generator, right? On the way.
Yes.
That generator is not there in the syllabus. It was there before. Now not there. So the 49th question. If you mark as 49, this is not in the first chapter. The question is in the second chapter, okay? Is it clear or no?
The first one, they're all the same charge or different?
So it's all plus?
All are plus, the first one.
Is it the same question? Which is the correct diagram?
Yeah, which is the correct diagram? No, which cannot...
Not, which is not the correct diagram.
Which is not the correct.
First one is all, it can't go from positive to positive.
Positive, right? Positive, yeah.
So it's easy to find violations always. One yes. violation is enough to say it's wrong.
Yeah.
The first one is wrong because.
Yeah. It can't start and end at the same point, same charge.
Point number two. Okay, then two more properties comes in this, what we left actually. Can electric field lines form closed path?
No.
Because a positive test charge can start moving from positive. Can it come back to positive?
No.
So number two is correct. Number two, you can, this no. is C.
No, you can C is wrong.
Closed path. It's a closed path
that
here.
Can't happen.
So electric field lines cannot form closed path.
Yes.
Okay.
So
that also not possible. This is a written conductor inside. This is a conductor piece.
It's not perpendicular at all.
Yeah, all the field lines are not perpendicular. And the last one.
It has one is right. Correct.
This is correct.
Yeah.
So only C is possible. Only C is possible, the rest are not possible.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So why is the question saying cannot represent? So then okay, now man, got it.
Cannot is easy to find.
Yes, sir.
Can means you check so much properties. All the properties satisfied or not.
Yes, sir.
Cannot, you can say because of what reason, like this, not because of this, that, not because of that, like.
Yes, sir.
So if this is done, the next concepts or important derivations from here, all are 3-mark questions going to be like based on this. So for 3-mark questions, all comes as numerical questions only. There's no big concept came as derivation. From here onwards, solved with derivations till the end of the chapter. 3-mark questions, part of 5-mark questions. Do you get it how you apply the net field, net force? Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
So if that is clear, the next topic you don't want to see as a derivation, you can treat it as a numerical question. It is same like that only. Just 1 minute, okay? You can have 2 minutes break.
Thank you, sir.
Why you laughing?
Oh my God. I don't know. I'm laughing.
Guys, Aishwarya asked the same question on the group.
Yeah, I just sent it on the group.
Right, and she
yeah,
said...
Yeah, I saw. Okay. Hey, Anusha, show your face.
Hi, Anusha. Long time no see, Anusha. Show us your face, Anusha.
So what if you colored your hair? How will we know?
Come on, Anusha.
Come on,
yes. Anusha.
2 minutes.
Because, like, I'm using iPad.
So yeah, what? So even I'm using iPad.
So, Kevin, we're all using that. Sri Lakshmi. Is Nandana still there or no? Right?
Lakshmi is there.
Oh, Sri, my Wi-Fi didn't like collapse. I'm so happy. My eyes are paining so bad.
Yeah,
yeah, in the middle, she looked like she was gonna cry.
Yeah, I was binge watching the whole day, so now I'm just like, God.
Wait. Can we put up the background?
Please. Do that.
I'm trying to find something that I can use.
You can go to stop video and choose virtual background.
Stop video.
See, I did something which like doesn't show my camera on it anymore, so I don't know how to undo
it. I don't have any options. That's so sad. Oh, I have to add image. Wait, where do you go for virtual?
Yeah, where do you go? Divya, why are you upset?
I used to do this shit.
Video?
But I don't have any. It's upside down.
Hey, I'm
going to do it soon.
Divya, smile once, okay? Yay!
But, Alina, you downloaded or? I downloaded.
Ah.
I'm trying to use something from, like, my camera.
How did Divya go upside down?
But how?
You can rotate. Yeah. It says on... Go
Man, what
again.
App are you guys even using?
No, go to stop video. Go next to stop video. There's an arrow.
What is this?
Near stop video, there's a small arrow thing. Press
where
that.
Is stop video?
On your left side corner. Bottom corner.
Mic. Okay, there's a mute and then there's a stop video.
I'm trying to find like a sunset or something.
Just stop video.
Guys,
oh, Alina's also upside down. Wow.
But how?
Sakshi is
half. What is happening?
How do I turn upside down?
Neharika, listen. You have your mic and then you have your stop video, yeah? Next to that. And then you have an arrow.
Stop video. I don't have any arrow.
Press guys, down. He's recording the video.
He won't see it. So
no, I have share.
And then you choose virtual background.
But I have share content. I don't have.
Wow.
It's on the left.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. It's on the what?
I can't find
closer. Freya, come WhatsApp. Closer.
Check WhatsApp. I sent it.
Black and white.
Oh God, Shreya.
Oh Jesus.
Interesting.
How do I put myself?
Why are you black and white? What is
it? Dude, let's talk about it. Shreya,
remain
like this.
You're going to be like,
what? There's only what's electric field and you camouflage it out.
I'm using my iPad. I don't have that option.
Yeah, same, dude. I'm disappointed.
I have no hands, no?
Wait, I'll choose. Hard image.
What happened to you?
Okay, yeah, I'm going to go connect to the laptop because I want to look cool, too.
I'm trying to
do how did you do that?
I don't know. It happened.
No, I think it's because you don't have like a solid background at the back. So it's...
Okay, I saved another picture. Let me try.
Just
wow. Yeah, I'm going to keep this.
Oh, wow. Okay,
wait. Who changed what?
Wow.
Is that a disco? What is that?
Let's do it.
Can you see? It's a like Disney thing.
It's like at Hogwarts Prisoner of Azkaban cover.
Yeah, it's cool.
Guys, put fun background. Come on.
Wait, come on.
Yeah, I'm going on laptop. I'm joining.
Yeah, laptop's turning on.
Same.
Suggestions. Where can I be?
I hope it doesn't come.
You can be in Hawaii.
Bali, France.
Eiffel
Tower. How about Jade?
It. I'm rotating.
Dude, let him come and let's all do this.
Can you
all of us just like rotating?
Come now. Just keep yourself rotated, all of you.
Upside down. Okay, cool.
So nice.
You all gotta wait for me and Niharika.
Yeah, man.
Like some light effects. Are we keeping the background? Or are we rotating?
Background. I think
Shreya is already upside down. So.
Yeah, but why am I?
Like, I don't know what's
why?
What's Shreya put Varun Dhawan in your background, no?
No, like, you know, just standing.
Oh shit! No, host has to let me in.
Host has to let me in. Oh god.
By the time he comes, I can't put virtual background now. Crazy.
What if I just turn my camera like that?
How will you see what he's doing?
Let me wait. Okay. So that's Raya. That. Now am I upside down?
Yeah. Raya is upside down and appearing.
You're out of who could be out?
No. Oh no, I was trying to join from my laptop.
Okay, it's fine. Divya, you went to somewhere else. Your background is okay, fine, we'll come back to the point. Can you tell me what was your idea about electric dipole? What do you know, what do you remember about electric dipole? Any idea? You remember electric dipole?
Yes.
Yeah.
They're opposite charges.
Yeah.
The distance is taken as 2a.
Yeah.
The direction is from negative to positive.
Okay.
And yeah.
So if you see the term, better always just try to build the terms from the question, like. Electric. So electric means only what, plus or minus? And they say what? Dipole. Magnetic dipole, you remember what is magnetic dipole? Magnetic dipole is just a bar magnet. One side is north and one side is what, south. Same way, electric dipole means we have a system, one side plus and one side minus. It's not a bar magnet. It's any system. One side is plus and one side is minus, but both has to be equal. So it's a pair of equal charges with opposite signs. That's called electric dipole. So try to learn from the heading, like dipole, then electric or magnetic dipole, like this. Then what Alina started? He told all the properties, like if you have a minus and plus here, the distance between them is normally taken as 2a, half distance a, this point A, this point B, this point O. The distance between the two charges is called dipole
length.
It have a specific direction, it's a vector quantity. It's always directed from the
negative to positive.
Negative to positive. Electric field is directed from
positive to negative.
So dipole length is directed from negative to positive. Yes?
Yes, sir.
There's one more property you have to learn for dipole. That's called dipole moment.
2aq.
It's a product of
charge and dipole length.
Magnitude of one of the charge. Magnitude of one of the charge and the dipole length. Dipole length is a vector, so dipole moment also vector. Direction is from
negative to positive.
Negative to positive. Unit.
Coulomb meter.
Coulomb meter. So I told you, even centimeter wrong, be careful. Even MC is not applicable because that will be read as millicoulomb. You should write like this or even write in words. Coulomb meter. You want any review on electric dipole and dipole moment?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Fine. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So now the next point is, along with this, they ask how to find the electric field of a dipole. How to find the electric field intensity of a dipole along the axial line, along the equatorial line, at the center of the dipole, like 2-3 questions are coming normally. All we can treat as the numerical question type. You don't want to learn by heart.
Yes.
This is the first 3-mark question coming from the chapter. Dipole and dipole field. So, we are finding the electric field intensity along axial line of electric dipole. This also, I try always when you do, prefer to start from the question. The first thing is what? Electric dipole. So we should go for all the properties like minus, plus, point A, point B, minus Q, plus Q, central point is O, half distance is A, dipole moment is from minus to plus, that is equal to Q times of 2A. So this much is under the idea of electric dipole. Then the next point is what, axial line.
Yeah.
What's the meaning of axial line?
A straight line.
The straight line passing through the two charges. So if you draw a line like this, it's called the axial. So axial line. The next one is, your aim is to find
electric
field intensity. So you take a point anywhere along the axial line as C. So when you take C, you should always specify the distance. Normally you specify the distance from the center. Yeah.
O to C is taken as R.
Yeah, correct.
B to C is R minus A. R minus A.
Yeah.
And A to C is R plus A.
R plus A. Then check how many field at C, like the normal questions, what you do.
So R is C, right?
R is
O to C.
Yeah, O to C. Center of the dipole to the point C. So how many field at C, which direction, same, opposite, different direction, that will decide what to do. How many field at C?
Two.
Due to A and due to B.
Yeah, so which one is stronger, which one is weaker?
Due to B is stronger.
Yeah. So what's the direction of the field due to B?
Plus I cap.
Yeah. The only thing, I don't prefer you use I cap, it's not wrong, because if I put dipole like this, then how you get the field line then? Here, if this is C. Will it be I cap now?
No.
It will be J cap or minus J cap, right?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
What you told is not wrong. I'm keeping a universal direction. Universal direction means?
Accepted.
Yeah, it won't change even you change the dipole orientation. Okay, can you tell me which direction I cap in terms of P cap and minus P? What is P cap?
The dipole moment.
Yeah, dipole moment is from which side to which side?
Negative to positive.
Negative to positive.
Okay, technically left to right to right to left.
Left to right.
So the field at C due to B is which direction?
P cap.
Yeah. Electric field at C due to B is along P cap, right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
What about at C due to A?
A minus P cap.
Minus P cap. But strength will be less, right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Now, what's the direction of the net field? Which is stronger, that will tell you.
Plus P cap.
Plus P cap, right?
Yes.
So now I'm coming at a angle here. This is minus. This is plus. Which line will be axial line? This line? Right?
22, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Can you tell me the scheme here due to the plus charge? Direction? Plus charge.
Plus P cap.
Yeah. Is it still P cap only, no?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
So
yes, sir.
The P cap, if you use, the direction never change. But yes. If you use I cap, it will be I cap for this diagram, what you drawn in the big one. And for this case, will be what J cap, right? Okay. That's the only reason we use what?
P cap. P-cap.
That's only reason we use P cap. So now EC is equal to what?
ECB.
ECB plus ECA.
ECA.
Yeah. Then you find ECB and ECA. What is ECB? So I told you we are not treating this as a derivation. We are treating it as a numerical question.
K cube by minus A, the whole square.
C to B, right? R?
Minus
A whole square.
Direction?
Plus P cap.
Plus.
And what about ECA?
K cube by R plus A square. Minus
P cap. So you subtract.
Yeah. Greater minus smaller.
Do we open R minus A whole square or?
You can learn A plus B whole square minus. You don't open in the denominator, okay?
Okay, sir. So then
A plus B whole square minus A minus B whole square is 4AB. A plus B whole square minus A minus B whole square equal to, can you do in mind? Can you try in mind?
A square
get cancelled.
B square gets cancelled.
Cancelled.
No.
2AB?
Yeah. And then minus 2AB.
Before AB. No one will ask you to expand and solve, okay? What is A plus B into A minus B?
A square minus B square.
If you square on both sides, what will happen? You're squaring on both sides. A plus B the whole square.
So A 4 minus B 4.
No.
So it'll be A squared the whole square minus B squared the whole square plus 2A squared B square.
Yeah, but you don't want to go like that. This is enough for you.
Okay, no.
I squared on both sides. I squared here, I squared left also.
Why? So what's the point, sir? What do we get?
Oh, because that's coming up in the next step down.
Okay.
What will happen here if you take which one to which one you subtract?
ECB minus EC.
Greater minus smaller. Which is greater?
ECB.
Yeah. KQ by
R minus
Finally, yeah, you can take out.
P cap.
Then solve taking common factor out. There you can use the formulas on the right hand side. Take you out. So V R plus A the
whole square
minus by so here you can use a formula on the right hand side. This formula.
Or
what's A and B?
AR.
Yeah.
R square minus A.
Then the 4 you can split.
2 into 2.
Yeah. Also, this 4 will go. Come as 2 into 2.
R.
So A, Q, and 2 will go as P.
Yeah.
It will come as 1, 2 is left. A, R,
P.
P with P cap is P vector, right?
Yes.
So.
Y, R square minus A square, the whole square.
Is that the
so what happened? What happened? So you made 4 2 into 2 or 2 raised to 2?
No, I made 4 as 2 times of 2.
Yes, then where did the 2 go?
This 2, Q, A is gone as P.
Okay.
You remember?
P Yeah.
Then I wrote what would left now. This 2 is left, I wrote here. K is left, I wrote there. R is left, I wrote there.
Okay.
Fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Last one more step is there. It approximate for short dipole over large length. If R square is very, very large compared to S.
Then A square is negligible.
Yeah. So it will come as?
2K
R vector P. By
R is 4,
which R and all get cut. 2K P vector by R cube.
Yeah.
So we use that for the for solving numericals.
Yeah.
Okay.
2K P by R cube, right?
Yes.
Can you just quickly check any problem with that or not?
It's fine, sir.
Okay. So can you try the diagram for the equatorial one then?
Yes, sir.
Equatorial one.
Do we get triangle?
Yeah.
Can I clear the screen? That's clear, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Did you start or waiting for me?
Sir, we finished the diagram.
Okay. So minus plus A, B, O. Equatorial line means?
Perpendicular
bisector. You can make a note because they are sometimes like that also. They will not say equatorial line. You will just ask along the perpendicular bisector. So we draw the perpendicular bisector. And the point is C.
So it always has to bisect?
Yeah, that's called equatorial line.
Okay.
If you have a line like this, this is not equatorial.
Okay.
It's not equatorial. Equatorial has to be the perpendicular bisector always. So what is O to C?
R.
R. You remember one question for the electric field we had done, the last one?
Yes, sir.
Three charges.
Root 2.
Yeah, root 2. It's similar to that, but different types, right? Exactly same.
Yeah.
How many field at C?
Two.
Directions?
C due to A is towards A.
Yeah.
And C due to B is away from C.
Okay. So I don't have a space to draw. I didn't think about that. So I have to cut and paste this again. Okay, so the direction of field at C is towards A, as you told. This direction. And at C due to B's?
Away.
Okay. Fine.
Yes, sir.
So we call this as E C due to
B.
B. And this is E C due to A. So what is AC actually distance wise?
Root R square plus A square.
Same as BC also, right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So how do you find ECB or ECA, anyone?
ECA.
A.
A.
K. Q.
Q.
By R square. So R square plus A square.
Yeah, if you have a confusion, you should check what are the letters here. Which are the letters here?
C and A.
C and A, right? Just go and check C and A. That's a distance. C and A. So C A, this distance. Square of that. We already have AC here. So square of this. It will come as?
R square plus A square.
Again, whole square is there?
Mm-hmm.
No, I've seen children writing like that, okay? S square plus R square plus S square whole square. Keeping the previous one in mind, what? R minus A the whole square. Which direction? Which direction?
C2A.
C2A. What about ECP?
We can write
Q by R square plus A square.
Yeah.
B to E.
I'm giving a letter D.
C to
now
E.
We can do the resultant again, root 2.
Yeah.
Oh, you can't do root 2 because it's not 90 degree.
It looks.
Yeah, that's what I told you. You can't take like that. Even Srinidhar told before, looking like it's 90 degree, that you can't take granted.
Yes,
sir. So,
but aren't they equidistant from A and B are equidistant from O?
Yes.
And PO is perpendicular to the base.
Yes.
And AC and BC are also equal.
Yeah, but I can have it here also, right? Like this. That also equatorial, right?
Yeah.
Is it 90 degree now? Check.
No.
It will not be 90 degree, right? See?
Yeah.
Equatorial means any point, okay? Along that line.
Yes. And then what do we do?
There are two options for you. Option one, we follow the rule root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta.
Okay.
In that, you have to learn some trigonometric relations. So I don't go for that because all of you are not math.
Srilakshmi.
One, we resolve into cos theta, sine theta components.
Yes, sir.
Remember projectile U becomes U cos theta, U sine theta?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So we are resolving ECA. ECA is down like this.
Yeah.
When you resolve this, where the components will come?
You get CO as one component.
Yeah, CO as one component, then?
And
it's called rectangular components, means 90 degree. If this is a vector, if this is one component, the other component has to be joining them like this. That means here,
yes,
same, like this. Both are same, right? These two are same.
Parallel to OA.
Parallel to OA, yeah, correct. So if I draw that here, one component is here down, like Divya told. And the second component is here, like.
So that'll be sine theta, right?
Yeah, that will tell me how you decide cos and sine.
Theta is OCA. So
OCA, this angle is theta.
Sir,
yeah.
Okay, that's.
It'll be ECA cos theta, right?
Yeah. First, I'm writing here. This is theta. This angle is theta.
Yes, sir.
So if this is theta, you know, alternate interior angles like.
Yes.
Like this. This also will be theta, right?
Yes.
Yeah. This is theta. The adjacent component is always cos component.
Yes.
So the one towards left will be
E cos.
E C. So want to be E C A cos theta?
Yeah, correct. You are right. Thank you. ECA.
Cos theta.
Cos theta. And this one will be?
ECA sin theta.
ECA.
Now we are splitting ECB. So one component will come.
Extending C upward.
Yeah, C upward. Then the other component will come as?
Same as
ECB.
Parallel to this again.
So they'll cancel out?
Which one?
ECA cos theta and ECB sin theta? No.
ECA sin theta and ECB cos theta will cancel, right?
First, before that, you have to tell me which is cos and sin. If this is theta, do you agree with me this also theta?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
That is theta. This also theta, right?
Yes, sir.
No? Corresponding angles. This angle.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Yes. So if this is theta and this is ECB, which is cos component, which is sine component of ECB?
The one you're
pointing at?
Yeah, this one is ECB cos theta.
So this will be
ECB cos theta.
Cos theta. And this will be
ECB sine
theta. ECB.
So now you can tell me which all you feel get cancelled.
ECA sin theta
and ECB sin theta.
ECB sin theta.
Yeah, both are being equal and opposite. And which get added up?
ECA
cos theta.
Cos theta and ECB.
For example, you write one sentence like that. One sentence means ECB cos theta and
ECA.
Just 1 minute, okay. Yeah, then what's the resultant?
Along minus B.
Yeah, so how do you find the total?
And we'll be adding the cos theta, so 2 ECA cos theta.
Yeah. So the total will be coming as?
ECA cos theta plus.
Which direction both add up together? It's fine, right? I can change this diagram up, right? You've done this much.
Yes, sir.
So, equatorial. Equal to. Two times of ECA cos theta, right?
Along minus P cap.
Yeah, minus P cap. Thank you. Then you substitute the values. What is ECA?
K cube by R square plus A square.
And find cos theta from the diagram. This is theta.
A by root A square plus root R square.
Yeah, because OB by BC, right? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. OB is A, BC is here. BC is R square plus A square. So cos theta will be A by R square plus A square called as 1 by 2.
Yes.
So you can change to Q A S P.
Yeah.
To come as
B Q
A
K B vector or?
Yeah, because 2 Q A will together take as P, right?
Yes, sir.
A minus P cap by R square plus A square whole raised to
3 by 2.
Now you can change P vector.
P vector. So how to my, okay, got it.
Minus only means a direction, okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, by R square plus A square whole raised to 3 by 2.
3 by 2.
So in the last case you can neglect if
so minus
kp
by r cube.
Yeah, because a square will go square and 3 by 2 get cancelled r cube.
Yes, so
then you have to note one or two points. One, you finished?
Yes, sir.
See, both are important derivations along with the dipole, dipole moment, direction, vector, scalar, unit and all, okay? Now, first point is how the axial field and equatorial field are related.
Axial is twice.
It was 2 kp by r cube. And equatorial is minus kp by r cube. So if you take this point, that's magnitude wise, the axial is
twice equatorial.
Direction wise,
opposite.
Direction wise, one is along p cap and one is along minus p cap.
Yes,
minus.
Directions are opposite. What's the angle between E axial and E equatorial?
90.
Can you repeat your question?
What is the angle between E axial and E equatorial?
90.
One is along P cap, one is along minus P cap. So angle is?
180.
Okay. How E related to point charge? E related to R for a point charge?
Inversely.
Yeah, inversely how?
1 by R cube. To the square of the...
This is for?
Point charge.
Point charge. What about dipole?
1 by R cube.
Yeah. Whether axial or equatorial?
The cube of the distance.
Yeah. That means if you make the distance double, what happened to the field? You make the distance double.
Oh no.
This becomes
for point charge?
Yeah, both you can tell me. For point charge, tell me first. So the E becomes, E2 becomes 1/4 of E1. Yes?
Yes.
What about dipole?
Yes.
1/8.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
And what about the equatorial field with respect to the axial field? equatorial field with respect to the axial. Axial is double of equatorial, or equatorial is half of axial.
Yes.
So I want to tell you one more point. I think it's fine, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I remember. I think I told you 7:30 to 9:30, but still. If this is a point charge and this point is E, that is X. This X, same, I think, if you remember, I don't know, Z1, Z2, Z3, right? If E1 is equal to
E,
the same thing what we just discussed now.
E2 would be
1/4.
Yeah, that only E by 4.
E3 is E by 8.
This
is
point. Eight.
Yeah. E by?
8.
How?
No. Wait. 12?
E by 27.
Never mind.
Okay, how you got 4 here then?
2
and 2
into 2.
E by 60.
20.
We don't know.
27.
So you got R square, right? R square. So 2 square is 4, right?
So 4 square is 16.
3 square is.
Yeah.
Oh, 3 square is 9.
I said 9. Yeah, but it was
3
a fluke.
Square is 9.
The next point will be then E4.
16.
See, one. Just put that value 25. And find the square. Just put the value here and find the square. Where? Here.
Where? There. Oh, there, okay.
There, yeah.
What about here along the y-axis? Points are here.
Same, right?
Same. Because same, point but charge half. By half. This is point charge.
Is that equatorial?
Point charge. Okay. Okay. Point charge, there's no difference, right? Axial equatorial, right? For a point charge, every direction is same, right?
Yeah.
For dipole, it's different. Yeah. If this was a dipole, what will be E2 then?
1/8.
Yeah. Then it comes R cube. So put here 2 cube, what?
8.
What about E3?
E/27.
E3 is 27. That time, what about the field here? Equatorial.
It will
be half. So it's
E/2.
This E will be
E/2.
This will
then
be
E/16.
E/16. And this will be
E/54.
So they can get you can get a question, or they can give you a question like this by giving the value. Either they can ask you mark the field, or they can ask you by giving the field, what's the system here?
Sir, this is the graph, right? And we just mark the point, right?
It's not a graph, it is just value marking. We are not drawing the graph, right? I just plotted the point just to show that.
Okay.
Graph, normally we get a shape of something here, right?
Yes, sir.
So what they can tell you, this is a question like this in the book. It's asked for the boards like 1 year. That's what I told you. So if we check that question, after you do the topic, these two are done. It's a question if you see the diagram. They're asking the field as, I don't know, it's clear. It's clear. A, this point is A, B, C.
Yes, sir.
L is also A dash, B dash, C dash.
Yes, sir.
And they say A field is E, B field is E by 8, C field is E by 27, and A dash is E by 2, B dash is E by 16, C dash is E by 54. They're asking you what type of charge is here. Is it a point charge? Is it a dipole or something else? Like
dipole.
dipole because this is showing what variation?
RQ
variation. Not only that, A dash is half of A. Right?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
B dash is half of B, C dash is half of C. So A dash, B dash, C dash will be what line?
Equatorial
line. And ABC will be the?
Axial
line. So you should say the charge at the center is electric dipole.
Axial line.
Yeah. ABC is the axial line. A dash, B dash, C dash is the equatorial line. The reason being, ABC field show
cube variation.
1 by R cube variation. A dash, B dash, C dash show half of ABC. This is similar to that of the dipole. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
If they given A dash is also same as E, B dash also same as B, C dash also same as C, then?
Point charge.
Is it okay?
Yes, yes, sir.
So, you want me to stop now?
Yes, sir.
I'll mark the questions and stop. No, silence is clear, fine. Otherwise, you could have told me.
How can you send this to us as well?
Yeah, I'll send you now. Even I create a group, but I don't remember the IDs and all of you have the IDs with me or not. Just after this class, I'm creating a group. Can you just send me, you send me the ID before in the WhatsApp group or mail?
So you already had like our previous email ID, so you sent it directly email to that. ID?
So we didn't create a email.
So you can just put it on the Teams group, right?
Okay,
we have a Teams like that, group, right? Just put it.
Yeah, okay, now.
Yeah, the
team. I can send you directly. So that means you have to send me a mail. I'm creating a group of mail ID so that I can send you every time like that.
Yeah.
Okay. Fine with you? Because WhatsApp, if I load, the font will become like after some time fully loaded. Is it okay? Then you send me a mail. I'll attach and send you all of you now itself.
Yes. Yeah.
So homework, okay? Homework questions are till page number. Now exams are over, right? Page number 22 till 48.
28. Okay. So 20 what?
Page number 22.
Mm-hmm.
Or you want me to very specifically mark the questions?
Sir, so how many questions will be there?
Please control you, sir.
The first questions only you have done right in the beginning.
Yes, sir. Around 50.
Not 50. These questions only you have done before, till 21.
Okay.
I don't know you did. If you didn't do, you have to check that also. So how many questions you can do, tell me. There's no bargaining in that. We'll fix and go. Now, correct number of questions.
Sir, 10.
Okay. It's grade 12, okay.
The school. Okay, sir.
Are those two
okay? Can you mark? I didn't hear Sakshi.
Yeah.
We're doing school.
Okay. But some questions at least you get same, right?
Yes.
Sir. 48, 47, 46, you can count, okay? 45.
Yes, sir.
Forty-one, 42, 39, 38, 34, 33. You can tell me after counting, correct? I'm not counting.
9, 10. 10 over 43.
Told me how many 10 or 15?
10.
10 is done.
Okay, 10 is done.
10 is done. Yes.
So what were you counting?
Okay, two more. 27 and 28 done.
Yeah.
Okay, so
classes
Monday, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we don't have a timing, right? Now the timing will come in between Ramadan, right? Like the class, fasting.
Yes.
I think we don't have a school, then why don't you bring it down? Afternoon school will not be there anywhere Ramadan, right?
Yes.
Yes.
So 2 o'clock you are free. Alina, what time you have to be free for breaking the fasting? So is it fine? Some 3 to 5:30 or 2:30 to 5, something like that?
Yeah.
What we fix? 3 to 5:30?
So I have chem tutions on Monday as well.
This timing?
4:30 to 6:30, something.
Okay. So what about the other 2 days then? Sunday and Tuesday?
No, I don't know.
Are you free?
Yeah.
Tuesday is
Nandana. I can't hear.
Tuesday
is. So we can keep 2:30 to 4:30, right?
Yeah, that's
fine. 2:30 to 5. We are 2.5 hours, right?
Time
to finish topics. No, just not 2 hours we meet.
Sunday I'm free. So 2:30 to 4:30.
Sunday and Wednesday.
Sunday is free.
So Sunday and?
Sunday, Wednesday.
Temporary.
Okay, all are free Sunday and Wednesday?
Then, yeah.
Yes, so.
But Wednesday, I think I have a problem. I have to check with others. They normally have the class with the other group. Elena, we can't hear you.
You're guitaring.
Can you Alina, confirm? Can you text. Confirm through the group then?
No, sir.
Yes,
yes sir. We'll tell.
Okay, but confirm today itself, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll stop it then. I'll send you the material if you send me the ID. Now it's to create the group.
Yes, sir, sending.
Okay. Fine. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
sir.
You, sir.
Bye, sir. See you on Saturday again.
Bye, bye.
Saturday we have
meet by Saturday.
Saturday we have extra class first. Period is physics.
Yeah. And you're asked to check the numericals on electrostatics and come with the doubts.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Bye, bye.
Bye, bye.
Thank you,
sir. Sir, I sent the email IDs.
I'm sending now. I want to create a group yes, before of you send, like, okay?
Yes, sir. I sent everybody's, like, all of us, except okay. Anush and Shivakshmi, I'll send this.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll send mine.
Thank you, sir.